SimCenter Test Lab has a real unit system. So what does this mean? That means when I see millimeters in a display like this, Test Lab knows that's a unit of length or distance. And if I was to right-click and pick unit here, I can actually change that and view it in different units of length. So instead of millimeters, I could pick centimeters. Notice it says 2.5 here. When I pick centimeters, it scales it properly to centimeters. I can also go in and convert it to kilometers, or even convert it to inches or miles. Knowing the units also means that we can do math properly. So for example, if I pick processing here, I can double differentiate this displacement data to acceleration, and it scaled it properly. And I can also switch that acceleration then in turn to other units of acceleration. All of this unit information is managed in a separate tool outside of Test Lab called the SimCenter Test Lab Configuration and Unit Manager. If I open it up, and if you did have multiple versions on your system, use the newest one with the highest number. This has a list of all the units known inside of Test Lab. There are, in fact, multiple unit systems. So you can say select active unit. These actually all have the same units, but they're just different defaults. For example, English would show English units by default rather than metric units. If I was to look at the unit of acceleration, I can learn a little bit more here about how this is all managed. So I'll say find, and I'll type in acceleration. Hit find. Notice it found a lot of different spellings of acceleration, like acceleration over pressure, etc. But if I say match whole words, it'll find just plain acceleration, which is good. And here we can see that there's a default unit and some visible units. Those visible units match exactly what's visible in the display. So the term visible here decides what you can convert to in the display. Notice there's a lot of other invisible units with different spellings of G's. We'll explain how that works in a second. But I'm going to double click here on meter per second squared. And every unit in this list is actually composed of a combination of these seven basis units. In this case, it's a unit of length, meters, over second squared. So time is negative 2. And the default unit of length is a meter. Mass is kilogram. Time is seconds. And because it's a meter over second squared, the scale factor is 1. Everything is stored actually in the basis units. If I was to look at G's here, same basis units, but the scale factor from G's to meters per second squared is shown here, and that's how it knows how to translate the data from meters per second squared to G's and vice versa. There's also a dB reference, which gets used when you right-click here and you say format dB. That's what it uses to convert the values to dB. All of that is defined in this unit system. Now, when I display data, it comes up by default in some unit. So in this case, the default unit of displacement is millimeters, and that's what's shown by default when I drop it in the display. There was a little hint here where it had millimeters shown. But if I would like to see it in centimeters by default rather than millimeters, I come in here, double click, and switch centimeters to default, save my changes. Then I have to restart Test Lab. But the idea is that after I restart, and a restart is needed, the units of displacement should default to centimeters. I'll open my project again, move that from the display, go back. Notice it says centimeters, and now the data is shown in centimeters by default rather than millimeters. So another use of the unit table is to set the default units. Another interesting thing is that you'll notice in this case, there is units of displacement and length with different defaults. Or another example would be with units for measuring sound like pascals, pressure. We have units of pressure with pascals and this atmospheric pressure with a different default unit of bars. If I were measuring in test lab, I can actually pick the different default units. So here you can see I have vibration, which is defaulted to acceleration. I'm measuring sound pressure with a microphone, so I pick pressure with pascals. But I'm also going to measure hydraulic pressure on a pump. And that hydraulic pressure, I don't want it to be confused with sound pressure. So if I had pressure here, these units would look the same. In fact, I want to see the pressure from the hydraulic pump in a different default unit like bars. So I can set that up in the channel information. And what I'm doing there is setting a different quantity case setting. And that allows me then, if I've acquired the data, to look at the microphone data, for example, in pascals, but then the hydraulic pressure, if I put it in the back here, is in bars. So the units are kept with separate defaults, and it gives you a logical showing inside test lab for looking at these different units. Another use of the unit table, we see all these invisible units. And one of the things you'll notice is that these units, like Pascal versus PA, it's the same unit with a different spelling. Well, what's nice, if we have a file acquired by another data acquisition system, in that other acquisition system, people might be able to freely type whatever they want in the field because it's just the label, it's not an actual unit. That may not correspond to the default unit of pressure inside test lab. If I go here and I go in and view some universal files, I have one here with pascals. In this case, they may have typed in Pascal, but the software knows automatically to view it as PA, the default unit in SimCenter Test Lab, and it knows the actual quantity. Here's another universal file, and if I drop this in, you can see that the label they typed in was Pascals with an S. Well, that one does not appear in my list, so it didn't get mapped automatically. So it gets this unknown label inside the Y-axis. In this case, what I want to do, if I want to read from this file the units and map it to our correct test lab unit so I can do all my math manipulation and everything else, I will highlight that unit, Pascal, that I want to map it to. I'll say add unit here, and I'm going to type in the variant spelling Pascals. It has all the same information, but now I've added another unit to my list, Pascals, that's the same as PA, and it'll know to map that directly when accessing the file in the future. I'll double click back on PA though, and I'll make that the default again. I'll hit save, and again, I'll restart test lab. Reopen my project. And if I go to that display, it already mapped it to PA instead of showing unknown Pascals. Another use for these invisible units, which automatically map data from external files, is when you're doing CAN bus measurements. So if I go into CAN settings here, one of the things that gets used in CAN measurements is a DBC file. It's a decoder ring of all the signals that are coming over a digital bus in a vehicle. Again, users there can type in any unit they want, but in this case, we found DEG and we mapped it to degrees automatically. MS was mapped to time. Millibars was mapped to millibar, unit of force. Here we have some unknown units called unitless. Well, I can manually override and say, I think that would be best served by looking at a unit like slash ratio, for example, is unitless. Or I could add the word unitless into my unit table and map it there. So great things that units are known inside test lab so that math operations, unit conversions are all handled successfully. Thank you very much.